All right, welcome back. We got Alliance War number 7. This was one of my, I think, favorite wars in recent memory with strategy, but also one mistake that was very frustrating. But let's go through it. We got path 3. We're going to take Odin against this Hit Monkey. We did do the pre-fight, so we don't have to worry about the shock damage that we can get when he gets to the armor ups. He's got those charges there. When he gets to 10, he's going to get an armor up. If you hit him with an armor up, he's going to put some shocks on you. So we use the Odin pre-fights on Odin. Odin also has True Strike on special ones, and he's going to be able to, and he can get around the evade mechanic from Hit Monkey, as well as we've got a Spider Ham fight in section 2, and Odin is going to shut that down as well. So here you can see he's got like the True Strike on the special one, so I can go in and attack afterwards, and you can get those beautiful gray evade fails. You don't have to worry about that at all. So Odin does the job here. I like the strategy on that one. Path 2, we're going to go with a classic team of Apocalypse, Cable, and Magneto. First fight is, again, this is the strike counter. But this one is you're only going to get a special as you as Overseer gets over a bar of power. That's when I'm going to get a bar of power. So I'm going to do what I do as usual, try and slow down my combo beforehand or stop my combo short, and then go make sure I can get a 5-hit combo into special one. That is the goal. Overseer just got to be extra careful about his auto block mechanic after he throws a special. So there I actually just figured might as well push him to special two. It's fine, I'll just back off. Let him throw a special. If he decides to throw it, that becomes an issue later on a little bit, but not for the mistake. But here, we're going to go ahead, wait out his auto block timer, then go back in and do the same thing again. Again, cross a bar of power into a special one and do the same thing once again. So he's almost down. We just have to wait out the his auto block timer one more time. And now the fight is over. Over for Overseer. Okay, next up on path 2, we've got Guillotine 2099. This should be an easy Magneto fight. But it is brute force and power focus one, and I'm going to make one. This is not the big mistake, but there is going to be a mistake here. I should have just stuck with parry heavies. She is a missed defender, even though there I thought I went for a block or a parry and got clipped there, and that kind of stinks. Here I went for a counter on the special one specifically because of brute force, and I was feeling pretty confident about that one after doing it the first time, because again, because of brute force, if I so I go for another there, I thought I got the evade, and then boom, I get countered. I am not looking good at all. I feel like I'm gonna get screwed. I drop the special two. It almost takes her out. I survive the degen there, thank goodness, and I get rid of the brute force, and now I'm just gonna go throw combos and finish this fight. So very dicey, almost got destroyed completely, but we made it through. We'll just forget about it. Next, we got Strike Counter, this man thing. Used to be the big bad here and can still be really annoying, but you don't, with the miss mechanic, my goal here is like his miss defender. I just don't want to. I can start with the power boost one. I want to go straight into a special two and do my best. I put the concussion on and I do not want to trigger dex as much as possible. So here I back off, let him throw that heavy. I want to reapply the debuffs with the heavy, and then I want to reapply like the strike counter with a special one. So again, we're just going to reapply, get to a special, reapply the debuffs. I do trigger a dex there, but it does not, I think it was the concussion. You see, I only put one hit in there. I was worried about the miss. It didn't trigger the miss, so I back off again. Go ahead, throw the special one. The goal is just not to trigger any buffs if possible on this fight. So again, go ahead, go into a full combo, throw the special one, and this tricky man thing is done. So very happy with that one, feeling much better. Now we have a Mix Master Dormammu, also a Mist Defender. We're going in with Captain America Infinity War. I have a Tech Champion and the Cosmic Champion, so I'm going to get Armor Breaks and Petrifies, which are nice to have. I did put on the Power Back boost, and we're going to see that come into play. All I got to do on this one, I basically cannot take any damage from Dormammu there, like on his no buffs, no degen. So I'm a Defiance attacker, completely counters a Mist Defender. Also, I'm never going to trigger that Mist mechanic. This is just a regular Dorm fight, but you don't have to worry about his degen at all. So here I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to go parry, heavy into special 2, almost 80,000, right into a second one. It doesn't crit, gives me like a 16,000 attack there. But if I could have crit there, that would have been awesome to put back-to-back crits in. But really, all we got to do here is just, you know, it's just a Dormammu. And Captain America Infinity War, he is Sig 200, so it's guaranteed to get the debuffs on every parry. And we just absolutely slaughter this guy, and I think we actually pull off finishing this Mixed Master Dormammu with a full yellow bar. So after this fight, I was feeling extremely confident, maybe overconfident, but I was feeling really good about the way I was playing, even after that Guillotine 2099 debacle. And I go in against this EMP Mole Man, and I decide, even though ideally I should have either started with Apocalypse, but I was worried about not getting any specials, I went with a Defiance Champion. Okay, I figure I know I can't parry this guy at the beginning. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead. I can hit his block before he gets any monster mass. But my goal here is I want him to throw special ones. And I want him to build up until frenzy. Once he's in frenzy, I can parry heavy him the entire time. That is what I was thinking. My only mistake is that I'm doing this entire thing and I did not pay attention close enough to the bubble shield. Bubble shield is that red charge above me, and when he gets to 10, his next hit is going to be unblockable. So I knew about this going in, but as this fight went along, because I was going like a nice little slow method here, baiting special ones, you know, baiting some heavy attacks. So, and I'm doing this whole thing nicely. You're out, there we go, bait another heavy attack. But he's only at like 5 of the bubble shield charges. I'm not too concerned about it. Everything else is working out exactly what I'd like to see. Let him throw special ones. He just has to get to the 20 charges. And I figure I can go ahead and I can just build up to a special 3. I'll do the parry heavy into special 3 once he's in frenzy, and we'll get a lot of damage in. That is what I'm thinking. But I stopped at one point paying attention to the bubble shield right as he got into frenzy mode. I was like, oh, he's into the frenzy mode. I can go back and I can get my parries in. Okay, so you can see here, he's not at bubble shield. I go ahead, I do exactly what I want. So far, the strategy is working fine. It's not like the greatest counter, but I can go ahead and get a big special 3. I'm going to go ahead, parry heavy. Really happy about that. Forget about bubble shield. And then right there, I get clipped and destroyed. I was frustrated. I think I had stopped recording. I actually went in, screwed it up again with Captain America, then went in with Apocalypse. And Apocalypse, the thing is, he can't get his parries purified here. I went with a Power Start 1, made sure not to trigger Dex as much as I could here. And I probably could have done this from the beginning, and it would have been, it probably would have been better. But I was really happy with the strategy, but it screwed up. So 2 stupid deaths on that Mole Man. I took a bit of a break and then came back in. We got Path 3 in Section 2. I got Odin here. There's no armor ups on Spider-Ham, so anyone can do it. So I figure Odin, again, with his special 1, I'll start with a Power Start 1, and then he gets the True Strike on his special one. So as long as I keep that up, I do not have to worry about Spider-Ham's evades, which is usually the most annoying part, because then he gets evades and he goes unblockable. So I just want Spider-Ham to throw special ones. And other than, I think, one point during this fight where Spider-Ham just decides not to throw a special, and that might be here. So I'm just trying to give him an opening. There he throws it. I think there's one more spot where maybe he was felt a little stingy, but I like that. Special one, I can get the nice evade fails again on the right side. That's what I like to see against a tricky evade champion. So here we back off again, try and hit into the block a little bit, trying to bait an opening. Spider-Ham does not want, I do not want to push him to a special two. That is, I just do not want to deal with that at all. Finally, throws a special. And now we can go back into throwing the special one. And we're fine. We get ours off. We're back to, we've got our true sense active, our true strike active again. So this works out great. So the strategy on this fight worked completely fine. But then we have a couple more really fun ones in this war. Sorry, this one's just a little slow. And down goes Spider-Ham. Next up, we had, again, a missed defender, which is why I wanted Captain America. And I brought Doc Ock along for the as a tech champion. It puts Petrifies on, so I can mitigate Sorcerer Supreme's power here. And as a miss, as a defiance attacker, I have no buffs. I don't have to worry about the misses at all. I can just play regular Cap Infinity War, parry heavy into special two, get some nice big damage there. And again, he gets that fury on the heavy, so you always want to heavy into special to do your most damage with Cap Infinity War. So there's special, you know, heavy into special one. Here, we're just going to take that special one on the block. And again, pretty tanky. Even as a five-star SIG 200, he's great. So another one. Now, Cap was going to be my... originally, I was going to use him for my thumbnail picture, but Doc Ock took the cake later on for a great fight against Mangog. But here we go for a Horseman. We had no fights in Section 2 on Path 2. We just had this, the Mini, which is a Guardian. He's hashtag metal. So I can basically just, I can ignore the Buffet node. All I got to do is be good at evading his special ones over and over again. I'm likely not going to be able to rely on my power because it's strike counter. So I'm just going to go with, heavy attacks here. I am going to get, I think, one big special too. I also don't have to worry about him auto-blocking anything, again, because he's hashtag metal. There we get that big special too. Takes about half of his damage away. Still getting some nice clean evades. I'm getting the willpower healing from the shocks or the bleeds, and I can... basically topped off. I don't know if you guys all, I'm sure you guys all saw that there. The game completely froze on me in the middle, and I just held block, and I'm like, please block that special. Please block that special, because the lag was completely crazy and got me a little nervous there that I was going to get smashed by a special one. But that's fine. I know that we're not going to be able to get to much more bars of power on this one, so there, a little bit of a block and dex on that special one. But you can see we're, from the willpower healing, we're sitting around 100% health. Really not concerned at all. Just going to go ahead, parry heavy my way to victory on this one. Get the, you know, get some nice damage on each heavy. Again, waiting out that special. There we go. Another clean special one evade, followed by another one, and he's almost done. Really, we just got to get back into these parry heavies. You can see there, we got like a 5k crit on the heavy attack. That's what we want to see. We're also doing like some direct damage on the heavies. So a few more and we're done, or maybe another combo after this one. There we go. So finished with almost 100%. Fantastic. Now, Mangog on node 54 has got to be one of the most annoying nodes. He is a miss defender. So my strategy here is I remove dexterity. Okay? Now, I've tried this in the off-season with Doc Ock. And I like to throw special twos and then reapply with special one on this node. But a special two will trigger an armor up on Doc Ock, which will trigger the miss, and I will get completely all out of sorts in this fight. So my goal on this one, you can see I don't have dex on, but I can still evade his special one because it is not a projectile. I can just move back. My goal here was get to a special three, get him around, ideally less than a bar of power, but here he did get more than a bar of power, which is fine. But we're putting on the permanent, potentially permanent power drain. Okay, so he's power locked here. So what I can do is I can just reapply the power lock with a special one, and now he's completely power locked. The only thing I need to do is, which he does, he throws a special. Now that he's thrown a special, I do not have to worry about only throwing four hit combos. I don't have to worry about his, I can throw five hit combos. I don't have to worry about his hatred at all. At this point, the only time that hatred comes into play where he goes unblockable or unstoppable is going to be when he throws a special. But because I'm Doc Ock and I can just reapply this extended power lock from the special three with special ones, I can continuously throw special ones. Plus, he's got 200% extra power gain. I'm siphoning some of the power gain back that he would have gotten if it weren't for the power lock. So it's so easy to keep getting back to a special one. So you can see here, all I got to do now is just regular five hit combo into special one. He's at 10 hatred, but he can't throw a special, and he is completely power locked. Doc Ock completely shuts the node down. I just have to make sure I don't heavy attack. Heavy attack will get rid of the power lock. I just want to keep spamming special one, and we solo this one beautifully. I hope you guys enjoyed the war, and we'll see you in the next one.